Are you off for the summer and need something to do? Check out my review of the Xbox Live Game Pass coming up next on Mumbles. Welcome back, everyone, to another episode of Mumbles. Today, we aren't doing our traditional game review. I recently got the Xbox Game Pass, and I wanted to give you guys my thoughts and opinions on whether or not you guys should buy this Game Pass. So today, I am here to detail and give you my opinion on the Xbox Live Game Pass. Now, let me give you a few details about this Game Pass. The Xbox Live Game Pass can be picked up for $9.99 a month for both PC and console. Now, that is separate. So it's $14.99 if you want both of them in the Ultimate Edition. So if you want both of them, you can pay $14.99 on the Ultimate Pass. Or if you want just the Game Pass, you can pay $9.99. If you just want the PC Pass, you can pay $9.99. So it's up to you which one of those you want. Now, the Xbox Live Pass does offer some things other than just games. It offers you access to day one exclusive Xbox releases, such as Gears of War 5. It also allows you to save up to 20% on Xbox One purchases from existing Game Pass catalog. So let's say there's a game like Forza Horizon 4 that you love and you want that game. You can pay 20% off and get that game, and then you'll always have it. You don't have to have it on the Game Pass. So that is very helpful. You can also save 10% off related game add-ons and consumables, meaning DLC, things like that. If there's let's say there's a game on the Game Pass like Forza Horizon, and it has a DLC for it, you can pay a 10% off that DLC and get it for 10% off, and then play it. So there is some perks to this. But we all know the reason to get the Game Pass is for the games. So I'm going to read you guys some of the names of some of the games, and I'm going to be showing you on the screen like their entire catalog as I go through these couple of names. The games on this Game Pass include things such as Sniper Elite 4, Batman Arkham Knight, Void Bastards, Hollow Knight, Crackdown 3, Shadow of the Tomb Raider, Vampyra, Prey, Metro Exodus, PUBG, Just Cause 4, Ark, Minecraft, Sea of Thieves, Forza Horizon 4, Dead by Daylight, Hitman, Lego Batman 3, Snake Pass, and Super Lucky Tail. So there's something for the kids. There's something for you. This thing all of a sudden has taken off, and it has a load of games. So these are just some of the games that are available on the Xbox Live Pass at this point. There will be more games coming to it. There's games added to it each and every month. And Xbox exclusives go directly to the Game Pass. So when Gears 5 launches later this year, it will come directly to the Game Pass. So you don't have to worry about buying it. You will have it on your Game Pass. I do have a con for this. My first and only con for this Game Pass is that I do wish that it had more of a bigger catalog of games. And I wish that games that launched would go directly to the Game Pass. So, you know, things that we've just were announced at E3 this last week, things like the new Star Wars game and games like that. That would be great to have something like that on the Game Pass. Obviously, probably not going to happen, but it'd still be nice to have something like that on the Game Pass. All that's really left is to give my thoughts on the Xbox Game Pass. Now, I recently got this Game Pass mainly because I wanted to play Forza Horizon 4, and I didn't want to pay full price for the game. But since I've gotten it, I've started playing Crackdown. I've been playing Manuel Samuel. I've been playing, I'm going to be playing Metro Exodus. I've been playing Astroneer. I'm going to be playing Ark. I'm going to be playing Batman. There's so many games that I want to play on this Game Pass, more than I thought there was, that I'm very pleased with it, guys. I definitely give the Xbox Live Game Pass a 4 out of 5 out of 5 stars on our Mumbles review. I just feel like this is a no-brainer, guys. If you ever used to rent games as a kid, and that was a big part of my childhood, I really enjoyed going to the video store and getting to rent games. This is something great. It's great for kids. It's got kid-friendly games on it. It's great for adults. It's great for everyone. I definitely recommend you check it out. And Xbox is always running specials on it, so you can probably get it some kind of deal on your first couple months. Anyways, guys, this has been my review of the Xbox One Game Pass. I hope you guys all enjoyed it. Please smack that subscribe button, smack that like button, smack all those buttons. And I'll see you guys all in the next video. Bye-bye, everyone. Take care.